फ्रेंड्स, हियर वी हैव टू स्टडी द कोर्स पब्लिक हेल्थ इंजीनियरिंग हैविंग सब्जेक्ट कोड 22504 फॉर ऑल द डिप्लोमा इन MSBT. सो माई सेल्फ AS भुमरे, लेक्चरर इन सिविल डिपार्टमेंट एट CSMSS पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज. सो वॉट इज द कॉम्पिटेंसी ऑफ दिस कोर्स, वॉट डज दिस कोर्स ऑफर्स यू, राइट? The main aim of this course is execute the efficient water supply system and sanitary system, right? You may be able to do this at least, right? So the course outcomes of this course, these are the main things which you get understand or which will you get understand in this course, and you will be able to solve any problem related with these things which this course offers you, right? Those are number one or A, identify source and characteristics of water and wastewater, estimate the quantity of drinking water and wastewater, draw the labeled system of plumbing for building sanitation. Fourth, draw the flow diagram for the process of treatment of water and wastewater. Last one, identify various accessories for the efficient conveyance and distribution of water. It means in this course you will get knowledge about the collection of water or source of water, then treatment of water and conveyance or distribution of water, and again collection of wastewater, treatment of wastewater and disposal of that treated water. Which body in our country and state regulates this process, you have also studied that things. Environmental concern or permissible limits of wastewater, also the permissible or norms for the drinking water, you have to study in this course. So scheme of this examination or the scheme of this course is as: there will be the one end semester examination of 70 marks and 3-hour duration. You have to score at least 28 marks or minimum 28 marks. And you will also have the end semester examination which will conducted by the external teacher. It means external oral examination of 25 marks. And 25 marks are allotted for your progressive assessment. It means practical performances and behavior of practical, right? Then number one, unit one or chapter one of this course will be about source, quantity and quality of water. Understand the source of water, quality of that water and quantity of the water which you have to distribute in the city or your locality or that given area. So in this chapter, we will study of the sources of water. Intake structure, it means the structures built on the water sources to draw some water for the treatment or distribution are called as intake structure. Then flow diagram of water supply scheme in the given situation. Then methodology of forecasting the population. Why we have to forecast the population? Basically, civil engineers have to forecast the populations mainly for the distribution of the water and collection of the wastewater for the treatment process. We will get a raw idea about the quantity of water which we have to distribute or convey for the population in that area. So then explain the methodology of distribution of forecasting the population. And last one, undertake physical, chemical and biological test for the given sample of water. Before distribution of that water, you have to take the physical, chemical and biological test for that water. It means it is a part of your water treatment which we are studying in unit 2, the purification of water, right? In this unit we will understand the processes by which we can treat the water, make it drinkable. So in this unit, explain the term aeration of water, These are all are the processes of purification or treatment of water. Then adding the optimum doses of coagulants, then describe the process of filtration. Next, sand filters, which are of two types, slow sand filter and rapid sand filter. Then the methods of disinfectionation for the given water sample. And last one, advanced treatment method such as ultraviolet, then adding certain kind of minerals in that water sample or given water to treat it or remove the impurities which cannot be removed by above mentioned processes, right? In this unit 3, we will discuss about the conveyance and distribution of water, right? It means the distribution system we have to study about any locality or any city. In this unit, we will discuss the conveyance system of water, then the type of walls, then distribution of water, then relevant method of distribution of water in the given area, and last, draw the layout of water distribution system in the given situation, right? Then unit number 4, domestic sewage and the system of sewerage, right? Once water is distributed, then it is utilized or consumed by the population, and wastewater will be collected through the sanitation system and then it will be treated. So what will be the sanitary water, how to collect the sanitary water, how to treat it and dispose that sanitary water again in nature. We have to study all this process in this unit. Justify the content of these units are: justify the necessity of sanitation for the given building, describe the various types of traps for the given situation with the sketches, describe the relevant system of plumbing in the given situation, draw the layout plan of drainage system for the given building, describe the testing procedure for the given sewerage, explain the necessity of manhole and drop manhole in the given sewerage system. Right, we will discuss all these key points in our next videos. And last one is 5th unit, characteristics and treatment of sewerage. Once we collected this sewer water, then we have to treat it, right? In this unit, we will discuss, evaluate the characteristics of given sewerage, explain the terms BOD and COD, explain the quality of treated sewer as per the given norms of MPCB, draw the flow diagram for the sewerage treatment plant for the given data, and select the relevant method of treatments of the sewage in the given situation. Here, there are certain keywords like BOD and COD, MPCB. All these points we will discuss in our next lectures, which contains all data about these units. So, these all are the content of Unit 5, which is characteristics and treatment of sewerage. So, friends, this is all about our curriculum and the content of the course. Now we will start from unit 1 from next lecture. So if anybody is having any question in this video session, please comment it on comment section, right? Thank you.